Welcome to Baxter Bell Yoga. I'm Baxter Bell. I have three quick requests for you and then we'll get right into our video practice for today. Number one, please check out my website, baxterbell.com, where you can find access to my online yoga classes. You can find opportunities to dive deeper into your yoga learning and you can find more free content. Number two, please reach out to me personally at baxter@baxterbell.com if you'd like to set up a one-on-one session to improve your overall yoga practice, or if you'd like to address any health issues that you have with yoga therapy. Number three, if you enjoy this video and you find it helpful, please like it when you're done. That would be really helpful. So that's it. Let's take a look at what our practice for today is. All right, I'm excited for our pose today. We're gonna be doing a variation of Warrior One pose in which we're gonna have a different arm position in order to access the myofascial plane that runs from our elbow down the tricep muscle into the chest, down the front of the body and into our back leg. So we're gonna be doing this little interesting stretch today that is Warrior One. We'll call it the tricep stretch, but know that really we're gonna access the whole myofascial plane that runs down that side of the body. So to do this, really, all you need is an open space. You can use a sticky mat or not, depending on how much friction you have on your floor. If you don't want to use a mat, that's fine. And let's go ahead and we're going to bring our feet to the front of our mat. And let me do one quick little thing here. Just going to make a little shift in my lighting. Let's have our feet hip distance apart near the front of our mat. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to step our left foot back into the Warrior One footprint with the feet about hip distance apart. That back foot turns out just a little bit. Now with your hands on your hip, let's bend the front knee forward just a couple inches so we don't have to go very far. And I already start to get a really nice stretch in my back calf as I bend that front knee forward. From there, we're gonna take that left arm and reach it straight up towards the ceiling and bend the elbow and bring your fingertips down towards your left shoulder blade. So my fingertips are touching that area. And then bring your right hand up and over and cap that left elbow. Now keeping that front knee bent and the legs active, we're gonna lift the elbows and shoulder blades up towards the ceiling and then take your right thumb and find the bony ridge of the forearm bone of that left arm. Use your thumb to press down on that as you lift the elbows up, pressing back into the left heel, and feeling that almost from the front of your left ankle, up the front of the left leg, the front of the left side of the belly and chest, and up into that tricep area, you're creating more length. You're getting actually more length on that side of the body. Good, we're only gonna be here for about 6 to 8 breaths, but you could stay a little bit longer in your home practice. So feel free to do this longer if you like to. Reach the arms up for a moment, shake them out, and then as you bring the arms down, let's step the back foot forward. And just take a moment as you come into mountain pose for a moment, I can still feel the effects on that left side of my body of the actions that I just did. So notice if that's true for you as well. Now, we're gonna step the right foot straight back. Remember the right foot turns out just a little bit, my feet are hip distance apart, and with the hands on the hips, let's bring the front knee over the front ankle into the Warrior One position. Energizing back into that back heel, inhale the right arm forward and up, bend the elbow, bring the fingertips down towards the shoulder blade. And then reaching over with that left hand, we're gonna cap that right elbow, and thinking about both the shoulder blades and the elbows lifting up. Now, watch out, some people unconsciously straighten their front leg as they lift their shoulder blades up, so keep that front knee over the front ankle. And then again, use your left thumb to find that little bony ridge of the forearm bone on that right side. As you lift the shoulder blades and elbows up, press that left thumb down into that right forearm bone to get a little extra traction on the myofascial tissues. Think about this time, instead of starting at the ankle, start at the elbow on the right side. Run your awareness down the tricep muscle, down the front ribs and belly on the right side, across the right front hip, and down the front of that leg all the way to the ankle. Beautiful. So sense that you're making some more length and space there. And then go ahead and reach the arms up, shake the arms out, bring the arms down, and step forward into your mountain pose position. Take a moment in mountain pose. If you need to shake the arms or legs out a little bit, feel free to do that as a little release. So again, today's posture, Warrior One, with that tricep stretch, which again, really is affecting the whole myofascial tissues all the way down that side of the body. So a really nice way to open up the side body into the arm if you hold a lot of tension in those areas. Try that out this week in your home practice. let me know what you think. And don't forget to follow me on Facebook and YouTube at Baxter Bell Yoga. And why not try an online live streaming class with me this week if you haven't done so to this point in time. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'll look forward to seeing you next time. Namaste.